Hi, I'm Wesley Devore. I am the Director of Marketing here at PreSonus, and today I'm going to take you through the five big C's of running a big session. The first big C is consistency. Whether you're running a three-piece acoustic session or a 12-piece funk band, do it the same way every time. If you lay out your instrumentation the same way on the mixer consistently every single time, you'll always know around about where each channel sits, and you'll develop a kind of muscle memory. You'll also have a game plan going in because you know exactly what you're going to do. Usually audio engineers like to put the kick drum on channel one. It makes sense. It's the foundation of your mix. And I do that as well. If I'm doing two kick drums, like I am with this session where I have an outer kick and an inner kick, I always put the outer kick on channel one and the inner kick on channel two. I don't know why, out goes to in. I am an audio engineer, signal flow, it just makes sense to me. But it doesn't really matter, those finer points, just do what works for you and what makes logical sense to you and do it the same way every time, and then you'll always have a game plan. Big C number two. Cable management. Keep your cables clean, especially when you have a ton of musicians coming in. So for this session, we have six different people that are going to be in here playing and a lot of cables running every which way. So what I like to do is set up my mics, get everything positioned where it's going to be in the room, and then I start running cables. And so I take it from the mic to the wall plate, and I tidy up as I go. So if I'm going to run it under a rug to keep it out of the way, or I'm going to make a lane where I can gaff it later, I do that as I go. This has the added benefit of making it super easy to cable trace, and my favorite part, when I'm done miking, I'm done cable management too, and I'm ready to move on to the next task. Big C number three, cheat sheet. Write it down, and write it down immediately, every single time. So as I mic things, I run the cable from the mic to the wall, and then I write it down. The best part about this is it forces me to slow down and really think through my game plan and make sure that where I'm patching the mic is exactly where it's going to make sense later and not get me in a bind later on down the road where it gets harder and harder to fix things. And then once you've written everything down and you're done running all your lines, you take your cheat sheet from the live room to the control room and you continue to write it down as you make your patches into the mixer and into Studio One. And then when you're ready to start labeling channels on your mixer and tracks in Studio One, you know exactly where everything is, and it makes it really easy to troubleshoot as you're doing your line check later. Big C number four, color code. I am a big fan of color coding my cables. I like to put multicolored tape on all the connections going into the wall plate, and then I know at a glance what instrument is going where on the wall plate. I did not do that in here today, mainly because I didn't have any tape, but I did do it in the control room in my patch bay, so let's go take a look. So every instrument and mic in the live room had to be patched through our patch bay into our console, which is the way our studio here is set up. We have a bunch of different flavors of patch cables, and what I did here is I color-coded all of my patch cables to match the instruments. So anything related to the drummer and drums is green, that includes the inputs as well as the output to his mix. Yellow is the vocals, same thing, inputs to the patch bay as well as outputs to their monitor mix. This way I can know at a glance what's going where, and if something isn't working right, it's really easy to troubleshoot. When you have a TT bay like this and a bunch of patch points happening all at once, it's really easy to make the wrong one. And when you can see a group of channels which you know is supposed to go one way and they're going the wrong way, it's really easy to identify. I like to carry over whatever color coding I have going on my patch bay into my digital mixer, and so I color code my channels on the mixer, and then same thing in Studio One. That way, wherever I'm looking, whether I'm looking at the mixer, my Studio One session, my patch bay, I know that green means drums, blue means guitar, yellow means vocals, and it makes it really easy to track down a problem in a hurry. Big C number five, stay calm. You're making a record, it's supposed to be fun.